Hello guys and welcome back to our channel. Today I want to talk about Bohr effect, and specifically Bohr effect, of course, for freediving. And I mentioned the Bohr effect a couple of times in my previous videos. I done the video about the oxygen transportation in our body like a year ago. The link is going to be somewhere here. And also I made a video also a while ago about the hyperventilation, and usually in freediving when we talk about hyperventilation we're mentioning the Bohr effect as well. But today I decided to spend the entire video talking about the Bohr effect. But before we start, if you're a first time here, if you're new to my channel, don't forget to subscribe to this channel, because here you're gonna find a lot of useful information which helps you to become better and safer freediver. So what is a Bohr effect in general? So as you probably know, and again, if you don't know, check out my video about oxygen transportation. The oxygen is mainly transported in our body by connecting with the hemoglobin. So there is a small percentage of oxygen, like 5% or something, is going to be directly dissolved into our blood, but majority of the oxygen, the rest, like 95%, is going to be transported inside our cardiovascular system by the connection with the hemoglobin. So the oxygen is going to be connected, four molecules of oxygen is going to be connected with the hemoglobin, and this is how the blood is going to carry the oxygen through our body. So our hemoglobin can be loaded with the oxygen, and this is happens in our lungs, and it should be unloaded. So the oxygen should be unloaded in a different tissues. It's going to be your muscles, it's going to be your brain, your heart, any tissue need to receive oxygen to continue to produce energy. So loading and unloading. And here is the importance of the Bohr effect. Obviously the Bohr effect was named after the guy with the name Bohr, obviously. And this guy found out that the hemoglobin is gonna deattach oxygen in a better way with the presence of the high level of CO2. So when in tissue you have a high level of CO2, then this unloading phase is gonna become more effective. So when it's gonna be high level of CO2, then hemoglobin is gonna unload the oxygen in a better way. So one more time, let's to summarize what is the Bohr effect about. When the high CO2 is present, then this unloading phase have a more favorite conditions. So this is the Bohr effect. High level of CO2, oxygen more easily unloaded from the hemoglobin. And why it is important for freediving? So it can be important to understand two things. So first of all, when you're holding your breath, a few things happening. And one of the things is increase the level of your carbon dioxide. So you're holding your breath, you're not breathing, you're not exhaling, your carbon dioxide level is slowly going up, and then at some point you're gonna have an urge to breathe. And obviously, most of us, or like all of us, don't like this urge to breathe feeling. And you like, I have an urge to breathe, this is so bad, why I have it? And this is an understanding of the Bohr effect. It's maybe will help you to look at your urge to breathe from slightly different angle. So now when you have high level of CO2, just remind yourself that now unloading happens more easier, right? So this is again one of your protective mechanism of your body. You have a high presence of CO2. Now all of your tissue have an ability to extract more oxygen from the hemoglobin, because remember, when you're not holding your breath and hemoglobin circulating through your body, the oxygen extraction ratio is pretty low. But when you have a high presence of the CO2, and this is what happens during your breath hold, then oxygen extraction ratio is going to be much higher. You're going to be able to extract more oxygen from your hemoglobin. So this is the reason number one why you should know what is a Bohr effect. And reason number two, it is when you're trying to understand about hyperventilation. And once again, I made the video about hyperventilation a while ago, so you can find the link to this video somewhere here, and it's also going to be in the description. And when we do a hyperventilation, I mean, I don't do hyperventilation, I don't recommend you to do hyperventilation, but let's say if you do a hyperventilation, what's happening? You artificially decreasing the level of carbon dioxide in your blood. The blood which is leaving your lungs is going to have a low CO2 level than it should be. And when you have a low CO2 level, then the Bohr effect is going to be like suppressed, right? So now the oxygen have a higher affinity with the hemoglobin, and this is why unloading is going to be a little bit more complicated. And this is why one of the reasons why hyperventilation can lead to the blackout. There is even so-called hyperventilation-induced blackout, when you can theoretically lose your conscious if you're going to do like really, really intense hyperventilation. And one of the reasons why you're going to lose your conscious after severe hyperventilation is because the Bohr effect is going to be suppressed, because it's going to be really low CO2 level, and then the affinity to the oxygen, affinity of the oxygen to the hemoglobin is going to be higher, unloading is going to be compromised, and this is why your tissues, include your brain cells, is not going to receive enough oxygen. So for these two reasons, it's better to understand the Bohr effect. Of course, guys, if you want to learn more about Bohr effect, you can find tons of information online. I'm gonna put a couple of links in the description to this video, where you can find much more detailed explanation what is the Bohr effect. You're gonna find about dissociation, oxygen curve, etc., etc. So much more complicated information if you are such a person who looking to like dig really, really deep into this topic. So just check it out in the description, you're going to find this few important links. Okay guys, this is it. I hope that this video was helpful for some of you. If it was helpful, don't forget to click the like button. Let me know in comments what you want to see on my next videos, and I will see you next time.